Going to show you how to use QDA Miner Lite. It's a free software that you can use to analyze your qualitative data. What I'm going to show you is the first stage, which is uploading your document into the system and also entering all the demographic information. There are two things I'm going to show you. You are going to learn how to upload your transcript into the system and also demographic information. So follow me and let me show you how to do it. So let me share my screen. As you can see here, when you open QDA Miner Lite and you have to use a free version, you have to click on Use Free Edition. When you click on that, this is what you're going to see. And then we are going to start a new project. So you go into Project and click on New. One thing that you have to do is you have to click on Create a Project from the list of documents. Choose this one. And then you look for the document that you want to create or you want to bring into the system. I'm going to look for my document. So as you can see here, I have 5 transcripts, right, from 5 participants. So I'm going to bring them here. You can just select and then click on add. You select and add. Also, you can select all of them by clicking on the first one and also press on shift and click on the last one so that you can bring everything here. So you can see here that I have all my 5 transcripts here. These are the transcripts I'm going to upload into the system. So you click on create. And here it's, you know, you don't have to, it's asking whether you want to remove the images there. I don't have any image there. So I just leave things alone here and then click on okay. It's asking you the name for the project so that you can save it onto your computer. So you have to first look for a place to save. I want to save it here and I give it a name. So I'll just give it any name here, QDA Miner Lite demonstration. And then I click on save. It will take a few seconds for you to get all the information. So you can see that I have 5 transcripts, right? 1 from each participant, and I've provided that information. Oh, another thing that I just want to tell you is that before you send all your transcript into the system, you have to clean your data. You have to remove any identifiable information. You can also give them labels. So here you can see that I've given them P1, P2, P3 until P5. And then when you click on each person, you can be able to see the transcript. Cases area here will have all the transcripts that we have uploaded. And then under that, we have variables. And so the next step is to think about the variables that you want to bring into the system. So let's say if you collected demographic information, like the age, their experience, their gender and ethnicity, you can bring that information here. So how do you do that? There are 2 options. The first option is to go to variables and click on add, and then you'll be able to bring that information, or you can right click here and then you can add variables. So I'll go ahead and right click and click on add variables. And the first variable that I want to add is age. So I type age here, and there's an option for you to give a description, right? You don't have to do that, because if you know what the variable is all about, you don't have to describe what it is, right? So I'll leave that part there. And then I click on numeric because I'm going to put numbers there, right? And I check integer. If you have a floating point in terms of decimals, then you have to choose this one. But if you have a whole number, then you have to choose integer. And then when you finish, you have to click on add so that the information will be here, right? So you can see here that you have the name of the variable, you have the type of a variable. I don't have any description because I know what age is all about. You don't click on create yet. You can add all the variables that you are going to look into, or all the variables that are related to participant characteristics. So the next variable that I'm thinking about is gender. Here you have an option. There are 2 groups. There are males and females. So I choose nominal. If you have categorical variable, you choose the nominal, ordinal, right? And then it will ask you about the values. So you go to edit here And then you type the values or the options that you have based on the information participant gave you. So I have male, and then I click on enter, and I have female, right? So you can see here that when you finish one variable, you click on enter and then go to the next one, right? And then when you finish, you click on okay. And then you click on add. So you see when I click on add, that information is here. So the next variable is the years of experience. So I will just type experience. It doesn't allow you to type a lot of words or letters. And I think it doesn't allow you to give you a space. You just provide information that you know what it represents. So I know that this one is for the years of experience. They provided a year of experience and it's numeric, an integer. So I click on add. And the next one is ethnicity. Ethnicity is nominal because it's a categorical variable. I have three groups. So I have African, American, Caucasian, Asian American. So when you finish, you click on OK, and then you click on Add. Now I finished entering all the variables and also the options or the attributes. And when you finish, you click on Create, and you see that all the information is here, right? Now we have to assign the attributes to those variables, right? So let's say participant one, in terms of age, you have to provide that gender, experience, and ethnicity. How do you do that? You click on the age and then you type the age. Participant one is 37. Participant one is female. So you provide a female. And the work experience is 12. And then the person is African American. So you can do the same thing for the second group. But there's another strategy that you can use. When you go to variables and then you go to spreadsheet editor, you can open this spreadsheet and then put that information there, right? So instead of doing it for each of the participants, you have a table here and you can enter that information. So P2 is 55. You type 55 there. P3 is 70. P4 is 33. And P5 is 65. And then in terms of gender, male, male, female, female. Experience is 25. Years, P2, 35. P3 is Caucasian, African American, and then we have Asian American. All right. And then when you finish, you click on apply so that the information will be saved, and then you close it. So you see that when I finish, all the information is here. You see that there are two ways of doing it. You can do it here, right? Or you can just click go to variables and then the spreadsheet, and then you can enter all the information. So this is what I have for you. I've shown you how to upload all your transcript into the system, and I've shown you how to add the demographic information. In case you did focus group, it's the same thing. You just bring the document or the transcript for the focus group in here. For the focus group, because it's only one document, you may not be able to add all the age and gender and other things because you are dealing with all participants, not individual participants. So in case, let's say you did individual interviews and focus group, how do you add a focus group data? You go to cases and you go to add, and then you click on where the file is, and then you go to new value. And here you can say focus group one. Click on OK. In case you want to upload, you double click. And then you go to file and then you open and look for the transcript. And then you can select and then click on open, and then that information will come here. So that's how you'll be able to enter that information, right? But in our case, we don't have focus groups, so you can go ahead and delete that information. So let me delete the case because we don't have any focus group. So that's how you do it, right? For using this free software, if you want to upload your document and also bring your demographic variables, right? Thank you for your time. The next video, I'm going to show you how to do the coding. Thank you for your time.